So we're told circle P is below. This is circle P right over here. What is the arc measure of arc BC in degrees? So this is point B, this is point C. Let me pick a different color so you can see the arc. And since they only gave us two letters, we really want to find the minor arc. So we want to find the shorter arc between B and C. So the major arc would be the long way around. And if they wanted to specify the major arc, they would have had to give us three letters to force us to go the long way around. So B, if they said arc BAC or BDC, that would go the long way around. But since they just gave us just B and C, we assume it's going to be the minor arc. So we want to find that arc measure right over there. Now the arc measure is going to be the exact same measure in degrees as the measure of the angle, that the central angle that intercepts that arc. So it's going to be the same thing as the measure of this central angle, which is 4k plus 159 degrees. So if we can figure out what k is, we're going to know what this central angle measure is, and then that's going to be the same thing as this arc measure. So how do we figure that out? Well, what might jump out at you is that this angle, angle BPC that we care about, is vertical to angle APD. These are vertical angles. And vertical angles are going to have the same measure. They're going to have they are going to be congruent. So let's set these two measures equal to each other. So we know that 4k plus 159 is going to be equal to 2k plus 153. So let's get all of our k terms on the left-hand side and all of the non-k terms on the right-hand side. So let's subtract 2k from both sides. So we can subtract 2k from both sides. And let's subtract, well, let me just do that first. I don't want to skip steps. And so I got rid of the k's on the right-hand side, so it's just going to be left with the 153. And on the left-hand side, 4k minus 2k is 2k, and I still have plus 159. Now let's get rid of this 159 on the left-hand side, so let's subtract it. But if I do it on the left-hand side, I need to do it on the right-hand side as well. So subtract 159 from both sides. And I'm left with 2k is equal to 153 minus 159 is negative 6. So k is equal to, just divide both sides by 2, k is going to be equal to negative 3. Now you might be tempted to say, oh, negative 3, but that's not what we're trying. We're not just trying to solve for k. We're trying to figure out this angle measure, which is going to be the same as the arc measure that we care about. And that's just expressed in terms of k. So it's 4 times k plus 159. So that's going to be 4 times negative 3 plus 159. Well, what's that going to be? 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. Plus 159 is going to be 147. So this angle right over here has a measure of 147 degrees, and you can calculate that's the same thing as over here. 2 times negative 3 is negative 6, plus 153 is 147 degrees. These two are the same, and so 147 degrees. This angle measure is the same as the measure of arc BC. Let's do one more of these. Circle P is below. What is the arc measure of BC in degrees? Now, since they only gave us two letters, we can assume it is the minor arc. So we care about BC. We care about this right over here. And what is the measure of this arc is going to be the same thing as the measure of the central angle that intercepts that arc. And that measure is going to be the sum of these two angles. So it's going to be 4y plus 6 plus 7y minus 7. So what's that? 4y plus 7y, we can combine the y terms, is going to be 11y. And then 6 minus 7 is going to be negative 1. So it's going to be 11y minus 1. And how do we figure that out? Well, how do we figure out what y is? We need to figure out y is in order to figure out what 11y minus 1 is. Well, we know, let me write this down. So the angle that we care about is 11y minus 1. 11y minus 1. We know that that angle plus this big angle that I'm going to show in blue, that if we add them together, that it's going to be 360 degrees, because we would have gone all the way around the circle. So we know that 11y minus 1 plus 20y minus 11 is going to be equal to 360 degrees. And so now we can just solve for y. What is, let me get some new colors involved. What is 11y plus 20y? Well, that's going to be 31y. And then if I have negative 1 and negative 11, that's going to be negative, let me do this in a different color. So that's going to be negative 1, negative 11, that's negative 12. And that's going to be equal to 360 degrees. 360. So let's see, we could add 12 to both sides to get rid of that negative 12 right over there. And that's going to leave us with 31y is equal to 372. And so if we divide both sides by 31, it looks like 12. Yep, it'll go exactly 12 times. So y is equal to 12. Which is equal to 12. And remember, we weren't trying to solve for y, we were trying to solve for 11y minus 1. So what is 11 times 12? We know that y is 12. 11 times 12 minus 1. Let's see, 11 times 12 is 121. And then 121 minus 1 is going to be, oh, sorry, no, it's going to be, my multiplication tables are off, it's been a long day. 11 times 12 is going to be 132 minus 1 is going to be 131, and it's going to be in degrees, so 131 degrees. That's the measure of this angle, which is going to be the measure of minor arc BC.